Okay, so for this lesson, we are going to be talking about symbols. So symbols are primitive data types. Think of them like number or string or a Boolean. They're unique, they're immutable, so they're great and ideal for things like creating non-colliding property keys in objects. One of the main uses of symbols is to add unique property keys to objects so that they don't interfere or collide with other property keys. So let me show you how to create them and how to use them. So I'm going to create my symbol as a variable. And to create a symbol, you just use the built-in JavaScript syntax of symbol and then pass it a parameter. And I'm going to say this one is my unique symbol. There, you just created a symbol. So what that looks like when you're actually using that in objects. So let's say my object is here. And inside of it, I can use this special unique symbol as a property key. And how I do that is I surround it with closed brackets. So my symbol. And now I can set that to whatever I want, value or something. Okay, so if I want to access that property and that value, it's as simple as providing that symbol again. I'm going to go ahead and run this. And there you go, my symbol value appeared. Why is this important? Because if I try to create another symbol with the same exact property and add that into my object, my symbol two, I can run this and it works regardless, even though I use the same exact text string for both of those symbols. Because I set that string as the symbol type, no matter what, it still treats it as a separate symbol. No matter what, they will not collide. Symbols also can simulate private properties inside classes, as they are not accessible through standard object property enumerators. And so, say you have a class, right here, I have a class called Secret Holder. And inside of it is holding my secret key. And then additionally, I have a function called Reveal Secret. If it's called directly, I created a new instance of that class and passed in a parameter called my secret. And if I try to do a log statement of holder.secret key to try to find what that secret key is, or even if I try to brute force my way through all of the properties within this object, if I run this, all of them are undefined. So the normal ways of trying to see all the property names within it are not accessible through normal enumeration. But if I go ahead and call directly that reveal secret function that's there, which is not revealed to the user that is using the class necessarily, but instead if I call reveal secret, then it's intentionally calling the instance. But if instead I call reveal secret, because the context of this is still holding on to that symbol within the class, then I can finally reveal it. It's a little bit complicating. It's helpful to keep that knowledge in the back of your head that symbols are one way to keep class properties private.